Oh, hello, JSConf. I'm so glad and excited to be here. I'm Constanza. I'm from Buenos Aires, Argentina. And I'm a front-end developer at Mercado Libre. It's an e-commerce company from South America. And I'm part of Chicas Programando, a community of women that aims to make the tech industry in Argentina more diverse by giving workshops, hosting meetups, and creating a platform for displaying the profiles of women and non-binary devs for give them more visibility. But now, I'm here to talk about life, robots, and cats. Three of the most popular things on the internet, right? We're going to see in this presentation a child's life, designing a pet feeder and its main part, the building process, and potential use cases of home automation. So, when I was a four-year-old child, my family made me clean up my bedroom, put the toys away in boxes, and do the dishes, and sometimes sweep the patio. By then, I was so angry because all I wanted to do was to play with my friends and toys. It's right. So I used to have this dream that was about creating robots that could help me with these chores I had. But then I grew up, and I still have chores even more than before. And now I have two cats, Orson and Haku, and sometimes they had to wait for me to be fed. Needless to say, I rarely get home early if I give them the day serving in the morning. They did it by noon, and when I get home at night, they're hungry. So I needed to think of a way to give them the day serving twice a day. Right? Okay. So now I know, and that's why I decided to build a pet feeder. I know that nowadays there are a lot of options that fill our needs, but some are expensive and I can't afford them. Okay, that's the reason why I built the pet feeder. So then I started Googling a similar project that could guide me in the development. I saw a lot of examples. Most of them were built on Python, and the structure was just for one cat. However, what I needed was something that could feed both cats at the same time, because I don't have much space in my home, and because it's cheaper than have two machines, right? So I knew that I will need a serial dispenser as a container, a servo motor to move the container blades, and a microcontroller to run the program, but I didn't know which one, because there are a lot of it in the market. So I have to decide if I will use a Raspberry Pi or an Arduino or something else. For some reason, I thought that a Raspberry Pi will be the best option due to how easy to work with is its operating system. So someone lent me a Raspberry Pi, which I had to configure it from scratch as well. And I decided to use JavaScript to develop the feeder because I'm learning to program with this language. So I made research and found a platform called Johnny 5 that allows you to work in robotic systems with JavaScript. But before using Johnny 5, I installed Raspi IO, which is a plugin that that allows you to use Johnny 5 on the Raspberry. I used packages for run all of this stuff. I used Node.js. So the configuration of Raspi IO and Johnny 5 is pretty easy. You just have to install it and require the module in your JS file. As I never built something like that, and my knowledge on the subject was null. I know that from movies that there are conventions to connect for connecting the wires. So all I wanted to do was not to burn my house because it will be terrible. So. After the setup of the Raspberry Pi, the first thing I tried was to turn it on tiny lights, and to my surprise, it worked. So, thank you. So I dive into the world of servo motors, and I try to make one work. But that part wasn't that easy as I was expecting. So the Raspberry Pi has a lot of pins where to put the wires, but you can't use any. I connected wires to different pins, and the servo motor didn't work until I found out that there are some things that need to be connected to a specific pin. For example, controlling the servo motor blades. So to do that, you need to connect to a PWM, that is a pulse width modulation pin. And the Raspberry Pi has just four of them. So I connected to a wire that is a GPIO 18. And the other wires must be connected to a 5-volt pin and a ground pin. So during the process, I learned that not all servo motors are the same. Some of them turn 45 degrees, others 180 degrees, and there are some with continuous rotation. I used all of them until I found the one I need. So this is okay. This is a 45. Yes. I didn't know that you must consider the weight of what you want to move. So I had to try servo motors for different weights. My house was full of servos. Yeah, but I chose the one that can receive 3.2 kilos. So, I'm sorry. Yes, that was the problem because I can't make it stop the servo motors. So the food overflowed a lot of times all over the table. That drove my cats crazy. Fun fact, they heard the sound of the food getting out of the feeder and came running to me and started mewing. And that part was very funny. Yeah, four of them. But it turns out that to move a servo motor with continuous rotation, you need to move the blades clockwise. So it is necessary to set the top speed of the servo blades when you want to stop. So I set the feeder to give them the food twice a day. For that, I used an NPM package. You just have to set the minutes. Is there 15 minutes? And then the hours, and that's it. They eat at 8:15 and 9:15 p.m. So thanks to that, I left the pet feeder running. And thanks to that, I realized that the feeder wasn't working properly because it was letting out the food every hour. So they were crazy. Yes, they want to eat all the food they can see. So, I'm sorry. I spent a lot of time trying to figure out what was the problem, and I found out that the library, the package, wasn't working properly. So I replaced that package for another one, and everything goes right. So the feeder was almost done. But one day, my cats got up really, really early, like 5 a.m., and they started mewing loudly. I was so sleepy and tired to get up and fill their bowls. But I knew that if I didn't get up, they would keep crying. So that was the point where I thought that I should include a new feature. Send an email from the comfort of my bed and then go back to sleep. So I started researching, looking for other packages, and at that time I felt like this little cat sticking its nose in every package it found, till I got the right one for this project. So to develop this new feature, I found this package that allows you to set up the email configuration, and it was very easy to include this package in my project. And in this case, I wanted the feeder to start working only if I was the email sender. So this was the feeder before it became in a robot. And after a lot of time developing and testing Sasha, the feeder called Sasha. I finished it with this final structure, that's awesome, with a little help of my friend, because there are a lot of things that I can glue. So we include those tubes. Before that, was just one tube. I want to say that this separation of those two is made by hand, or was made by hand. So I can say that the dream that I had when I was a child came true. So. So building Sasha and getting all these achievements made me realize that I wanted to do more projects involving robotics, and that there are a lot of potential use cases of home automation that I would love to implement, like controlling non-smart things like lights or the air conditioner, or controlling the temperature of a room. So I think that you can build this feeder just with a little JavaScript knowledge. It's not too complicated. And it's a nice activity to teach how to code. Even if there are parts that involve not coding, like building the structure, gluing pieces, etc., why is a nice activity to teach to code? Because you can teach variables, conditionals, using packages, setting up microcontroller. So you are introducing the beginners to the art of setting up their computers. So I don't know much JavaScript because I started learning and to program like 2 years ago. But I'm sure that there are amazing projects to be built and to be shown. Maybe those projects can inspire others, other people to do things and to facilitate chores or change how they interact with their home just with a little bit of code. So that's I have.